On this episode of the R.A.H. War Series, more Aussies arrive in Egypt, and it's going to be a quiet Christmas. Hey mates, it's me Riz, and welcome to another episode of the R.A.H. War Series. Last month, the Australian Royal Navy had cleared out German ships from delaying the AIF troops to Egypt. This month, on the 2nd of December, the 6th, the 8th and the 12th Australian Battalion will arrive in Egypt, doing one of four things. On December 11th, Winston Churchill, First Lord of the Admiralty, had declared an Allied victory in the Pacific after the British naval victory at the Battle of the Falkland Islands. Although he did mention Australia and Japan's efforts, though it's kinda at the bottom. Anyway, let's get to Christmas. Now, Australian soldiers overseas during Christmas was very quiet, if only more homesick during the holidays. For context, around 50,000 troops are overseas by this month. No ANZAC troops that I know of took part in the Christmas truce on the Western Front. By the time Australians were on the Western Front, there would be no Christmas truce unless Santa was the British High Command and the presents were bombs. I'm sure they were festive. Soldiers from recruit to officer did as much effort to make the holidays more festive, whether they were overseas, on a ship, or at the training camp. So let's talk about Christmas on the home front. It's safe to say Christmas in 1914 was no different than 1913, with the exception of families together on Christmas. There was no rationing at all for families to restrict foods for Christmas lunch or Christmas dinner. Packages were sent by families and the Red Cross, letters, biscuits, coffee, pudding, just to name a few. Actually, fruit and pudding was the traditional food for an Australian Christmas at the time. Senior military historian Aaron Pagram has a few quotes about the 1914 Christmas in Egypt. Christmas is probably the only time in which the Australian soldiers actually eat considerably well. Troops were remarkably adept at procuring practically anything from the locals, so it would have been local cuisines that have been sourced. There was actually quite a roaring trade in terms of the fresh produce that was made locally through the local townspeople in Cairo. So you'd have fresh fruit, eggs, chicken. I've read letters and diaries of Australian troops actually feasting on things such as pork and chicken for that particular Christmas. It was probably one of the better Christmases they had for the duration of the First World War. And yeah, it was one of the better Christmases. It was actually a really quiet Christmas. I would like to end this episode with a quote from an Australian miner published on a Christmas magazine. "Today we toast those gallant boys of our own in far Egypt, our kingsmen in the trenches of France and Belgium, in the brave warships of England, and in every hole and corner of the world where their loyal hearts beat warm and true in love and pride of their country." Merry Christmas, everyone. Thanks for watching to the end of the video. Please like and subscribe. It brings a smile to my face. Again, Merry Christmas to all and to all a good night. And now I'm going to, play a video game. Damn, I got a lot of games. I'll have to prioritize them. Did I actually vote that in the script? Yes, I did. Created by Anthony Bezos, Sydney, Australia.